Welcome, dear viewers, to Couch Warrior TV on YouTube. I am the Couch Warrior, and you are watching The Passage, a Skyrim SE Let's Play featuring Ettient Jorel, the Altmer Ranger. Okay, let's see. I'm just making sure that I've got all the correct gear equipped. So, Ettient is really nervous about staying here. So, he got a quick 4 hours of sleep. And we are hitting the road in the dead of night. Our best guess is that this is really not what Jarl Balgruuf expected, the kind of behavior he expected from a new thane. But I will tell you that Ettient is a little bit frightened. He's not frightened for himself. He's frightened for his sister. And he's worried that if there are any further delays in him getting back, that his sister will be the one who ends up suffering for it. Thalmor. I think we can take this as a sign that we left Whiterun just in time, because it looks an awful lot like that group is headed for the city. So there is a lot of there are a lot of unknowns here. Ettient has rendered some very important services to the Jarl and the people of the city. He's become a hero and a thane. He's gained notoriety there. But we have no idea what Balgruuf and his people are going to say if the Thalmor show up and start asking questions. If they would defend Ettient, if they would hear stories of his exploits and change their opinions of him, he really has no idea. So, to his mind, the best policy is to get out of there as quickly as possible while he still can. What we don't need are any additional entanglements, especially when we've got a rather critical personal mission at hand. So, anyway, that's what we're doing. I think, you know, now is a good time also to obviously start thinking a bit more about the whole Dragonborn thing. We've seen Ettient start to really hold the Nordic people and their traditions in high regard. He still very much feels like an outsider, but my guess is that being treated with such respect by the Nords in Whiterun and being judged purely on the basis of his deeds as opposed to his reputation was quite refreshing to him, and one might even say I'm going to take the skeever out. I'm going to leave the wolf alone unless it attacks me. Skeever. Disease-carrying creatures. Not that the wolves aren't. But I think there's a higher likelihood of contracting something nasty with a skeever attack. What's this? Oh, Zenithar. Speech increase. So now we have some confirmation. Some confirmation that there is, in fact, some real significance to the strange feeling of power we get when we're in the presence of those walls, and that somehow that's tied to the dragons. The Nords believe firmly in these legends, and I think it, for Ettient, it speaks volumes that they spoke to him openly about that. And when they told him to try shouting, he did, and it worked. I think, to him, that's something real. That's something that a practical man like himself can't really ignore. What he knows for sure is that he witnessed what happened with the dragon's body afterwards. He felt the rush of power, which felt not unlike the same rush of power that he's felt in the past when nearing a word wall, except much, much more intense. And that somehow following that encounter, he seemed to be able to harness a power that he's never been able to before. Oh, big boy. Hey, this is your territory. We get that. Your territory. We're getting out of it. Didn't mean to intrude. I had mentioned in a previous episode that we're using a mod by one of the viewers of the Passage series named Elentarian. You can find that mod on the Nexus, and it just tweaks animal behavior so that they act a little bit more natural, like animals would in the wild. Less aggressive, you know? They will get aggressive with you if you push them. But for the most part, they kind of want to be left alone, much like we do. And I really like it. I think it's a great mod for anybody to use. But in Ettient's story specifically, I like to think of it as in a way kind of a kind of symbolic of Etienne's continuing ability to sort of be one with nature. So as his abilities as a ranger grow, he's become more attuned to the wildlife with all of this experience that we've had, and is now able to understand the wildlife of Skyrim to the point where he can avoid needless confrontation if he needs to. I sort of like that idea. So just an example of his continued growth as a ranger. Here's our bag of mystery. Troll skull. It's our forsworn stuff we ditched here. Kind of fun, actually. Nothing there we need. Interesting to note it's still here, though. That's cool. Right, sunrise is rapidly approaching. Got another bear ranging in this area. We encountered a bear here last time, so that's not completely unexpected. Forsworn are back. Son of a bitch. They've moved right back in. Well, it's the Thalmor's problem now. We've got other things to worry about. You can bet that Ettient is really not particularly interested in doing the Thalmor any favors, that's for sure. With the dissolution of his relationship with the Thalmor, that, for him, put an end to that farce of a war. He realizes now that they never had any intent of giving him his life back. They just wanted to use him and then throw him away. So he knows now that the whole thing was a complete farce. Let's see if we can pull some of this corundum out quick. Might be helpful to have a little bit of this on hand, as we've got some gear that can take advantage of it. If there's any chance of getting up here. Probably not. Let's head back up here. Whoa. Still the tremors. Feels almost strange to be back in the Reach. Definitely gonna harvest some juniper berries along the way, take advantage of our short time here in the Reach to gather some materials that we know are useful. Now, you. There you are. Just don't want to get bit. Where'd the vile thing go? Gotcha. You got any friends? So we left in such a hurry that we didn't really take the time to stock up on some food, and we're literally down to a couple of staples and water and cheese, and that is it. Like,
I knew it.
What? Oh, he's got us in a corner.
Lucky hit. I'll see you burn.
Yeah, come and get it. Who is this? What the hell? As instructed, you are to eliminate Ettient Jorel by any means necessary. The Black Sacrament has been performed. Somebody wants this poor fool dead. We've already received payment for the contract. Failure is not an option. Astrid. Well, shit. Ugh. Is it any accident that we gained this notoriety and suddenly overnight we've got an assassin attacking us on the road? In the open? Broad daylight? Now we've opened a whole new set of questions. The most likely candidate to hire an assassin would be the Thalmor. I mean, we know they want us dead. Badly. And if they believe us to be operating in Riften, and we know that they have trouble operating in Stormcloak territory, maybe they would resort to hiring an assassin to try to track us down. All right. We're gonna stop in here. Look at all the birds. See if we can stock up on some supplies.
Ah, a visitor. Old Hrolden Inn has hundreds of years of history, friend.
Hey.
Old Hrolden is the stone that the Empire's history is built on.
Listen. What have you got for sale?
Drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry.
Okay, I'm gonna take your Elta wine, baked potatoes. Wow, they have Blackbriar mead all the way out here. We need the protein, mostly. completely out of that. Refill our water.
Of course.
So, I'm interested in Tiber Septim. What's this Tiber Septim's room thing?
That's right. In the Second Era, Tiber Septim himself led the army that conquered Old Hroldan from the barbarians of the Reach. Septim would later found the empire that united Tamriel, but his first known battle and victory was right here.
Right.
And this inn has the very bed the great general slept in on his first night as Old Hroldan's liberator, as good as it was hundreds of years ago.
I don't know if I believe that.
Good day.
I've read about the battle, though. This bed?
Mama, where did Papa go?
Yeah, this talks about King Kulakane, who was an early ally of Talos. And some of the histories say that Talos betrayed Kulakane in the end, having him assassinated. I want to take this book.
He's off fighting the war, dear. For the Stormcloaks.
Last time you said he was fighting for the Empire.
Yep, I'm sure he's doing well there.
Are you telling me that that bed's from the Second Era?
Old Hroldan is the stone that the Empire's history is built on.
What's this? Oh, there's too much literature for a ranger to take in Skyrim. Hey, look.
Don't underestimate my son, Schooly. He may look young, but he can handle any drunks we get.
Oh, I don't doubt it. He looks like a stoic young man. Listen.
Schooly's father's off fighting for the Empire. I'm sure he's just fine.
Hey, you know?
Need something?
I was thinking, I could use some rest, and if Tiber Septim's bed is available, I might be interested in renting that.
Have a good rest. It's the big room with the double bed.
Okay.
I'll show you to your room, right this way.
I mean, I can't pass up an opportunity to sleep in the same bed Tiber Septim did, right?
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
This can't possibly be from the Second Era, right? Ugh, who gives a crap? I'm exhausted. All right. Gonna get some rest. We have put a lot of distance between us and Whiterun now, and he's basically running on 3 or 4 hours of sleep, so he's gonna crash. And something about the novelty of just the idea that it could possibly have been Tiber Septim's bed. What? What's happening? What? How long has it been there? Hey, how long has it been there?
Mara, have mercy, that gave me a fright. There's a ghost just wandering around my inn like it owned the place. Yes, I've heard stories that Old Hroldan was haunted, but no one's seen a ghost here since the Great War. He's from the battle, I just know it. He's one of Tiber Septim's soldiers, back from the dead.
Really? What the?
Yeah.
He's looking at me.
I fought by your side to take back the Reach from the savages.
What?
Hjalti? Is that you? I've been waiting.
Hjalti? What are you talking about?
You promised me, Hjalti. You promised that when we sack Folden, you would make me your sworn brother.
Okay.
And I've waited. Even after the enemy's arrows dug into my chest and their hammers crushed my bones, I've waited.
Okay.
Give me your sword, Hjalti, that we may become brothers, as you promised.
I'll find your sword.
I long to taste battle again.
Where are you from?
You don't remember me, Hjalti? Two campaigns we served together. You saved my life time and time again.
Well. Wow. We know from our readings that Hjalti was the name that Tiber Septim went by when he fought the battle in this area. All those many years ago, Hjalti Earlybeard was his name back then, and he would have had to have been a very young man at that point. And in our previous adventures, we found a sword that was dubbed Hjalti's sword. We found what he's looking for. We just have it stashed in one of our many camps. I wonder if we could find it again. Oh boy. Hey, I don't think he's going anywhere. So you're gonna have to deal with it. It might bring in some more patrons. Look at it as an opportunity. What did we do with that sword? We probably left it in one of our base camps. All right. Okay, this might be better for us to travel at night. Okay, we're gonna stay off the road. We're gonna cut up this way. This will take us up to this small village. The sinkhole, we can cut through there. And we've got a couple of different options at that point to rejoin the roads. Oh, shit. Great. All right. Nice and easy, big boy. Get down here. All right, here we are. Soljund's sinkhole.
Whoa there!
I don't know where you're going, but stay out of that mine. It isn't safe. Hundreds of
years. I'm not going in there. Don't worry about it.
We're gonna need an army to clear out that crypt.
Well, it stands to reason that The Forsworn certainly have every reason to hate Etienne's guts. So the Hound, even though he's basically called off his war on the Forsworn, he is not at all interested in letting them know he's back in the hold. That could be a very big problem for him. So we're going to do our best to stay off their radar, even if it means getting a little wet. That. Wow. Interesting to see mud crab going inland like that. I wonder where he's headed. Imperials? Yeah, it looks like it. We can't trust the Imperials either. So best to avoid them as well. This. Maybe someone else avoiding the Imperials? Let's keep moving. They're going exactly the direction we need to go. All right, let's take a little time out. Someone's coming this way. Forsworn. Not our problem, damn it. All right. I think one important option we have here is there's a significant amount of risk for us sneaking into Markarth. And Etienne's going to be very, very aware of this. I mean, it's a city that is controlled by the Imperials, has representatives of the Thalmor right in it. We need very much not to be seen there. So let's do a time check. All right. So we need to get this done tonight and get out. It's interesting how quickly things change. I mean, the Reach used to be our turf, our playground, you know? And now it's extremely dangerous. So we're going to take advantage of the fact that we're arriving at night, and we're going to try to slip in undetected, have this conversation that we need to have, and get the heck out. And, I mean, we're putting an awful lot of faith right now in Maven. In the fact that she wouldn't send us on a mission like this if there were the slightest chance that it wasn't important. And we're having to have some faith as well that she's got enough that she wants to use us for, that she isn't just setting a trap and, you know, driving us back into the Reach and into the hands of the Thalmor for money or something like that. I think that there's also just logic that supports that this isn't the case. I mean, Maven is extremely wealthy. She has her own agenda. She doesn't need money from the Thalmor. But it could be possible that she's trying to curry some favor with them or something. So, Ettient is operating under the assumption that everyone is the enemy and that this whole thing is a trap. It's the only way he can be absolutely certain he's doing everything in his power to be smart and to play it safe, right? All right. This is it. This is our spot. See if we can pull this off. Okay. Gotta watch for the guards now. Let's get right on in here as quick as we can.
Come on in. The Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink and clean rooms.
Hey, come here. Damn it, come here.
Clepper, you idiot! Can't you do anything right?
Never mind that.
It's you.
You're talking to me right now.
Sorry to hear about your imprisonment. I'm sure the guards didn't mean to throw you in jail.
Yeah, I'm sure. Hey, I have a purchase agreement for you. Let's get this over with.
Bowley finally got someone out here. Well, it's about time. I've been waiting for weeks. Well, thank you for bringing it, I suppose. Have a good day.
Yeah.
What?
You're forgetting something. Let's do this.
How could I have possibly forgotten? Your reward, of course.
Of course.
Of course. Here you are. So sorry about that.
All right. We can do that.
Remember, ale is cheaper than blood in Markarth.
Right. All right, we gotta get out of here. Guard by the door. He's coming back. Can I get in here? Oh, crap. Okay, we climbed down a rope. What do we get ourselves into here? Come out. Oh, through that hole right there. Wow. We've walked right past it before. All right, good to know. Oh, man. Bowley, you owe us big time for this. Very deep. Okay, we're sticking to the waterways. It's going to be miserable and freezing cold. Could be the only safe way through this mess. Stick along the edge of this pond. If we can get around to the other side, we can bolt up the road as fast as we can. I think under the circumstances, we are going to Jeets are here, too. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for watching this episode. I'm going to call it right here. Etienne's got to make a plan as to what he's going to do next. Food, rest, warmth, and dry clothing is the order of the day. So We're going to be thinking about that and planning out our next move. I will see you next time.